Good morning, students. Welcome you all to today's English class. Children, today we will study the second lesson from the book Footprint Without Feet, The Thief's Story. We have already read some part of this lesson and we will continue with the rest part. But before we start, let's summarize what we have already read. Children, as we know that the narrator of this story is a thief. He has given his false name Hari Singh to Anil, and he befriends Anil, and his main motive is to rob him. But ultimately, when he reaches home and he found that Anil was a very honest and trustworthy person, slowly and gradually his mind changes. Okay, and although he makes money every day by buying grocery and vegetables and all that, but slowly and gradually he is learning. Okay, he is being educated by Anil, and that transforms him to some extent. But one day what happens that Anil comes with a bundle of notes, and now Hari Singh, he starts thinking that he has done nothing for last 1 month in his field. He has not robbed anyone, so it was the best chance that he could rob Anil. So he had already seen him putting the money under the mattress, so he had already planned everything that today he would rob Anil. Otherwise Anil would spend all that money on his friends, so it is the right time that he should rob him. So now let's read whether he robs him, what he does with the money that he robs, whether he takes to that person, whether he moves away or he comes back, his heart changes. Okay, this is all a part of the story. Let's read and find out what is all given in the next part. Yes, so now he was just thinking about robbing him, and what he says that it is really very difficult to rob him, and that is why it was so difficult to rob him, because he was the most trusting person he had ever met. He had not met anybody like that. It is easy to rob a greedy man because he can afford to be robbed. So you can easily rob a greedy man. Greedy man, he counts the money every time and he is very greedy about money. So he can afford to be robbed. Okay, you can rob him and he finds out what has been lost. But it is really difficult to rob a careless man, because careless man, he never counts the money, he never keeps the records. So if you rob any careless person, it takes out the pleasure out of work, that a thief is never pleased to rob a careless man, because he can never notice. The careless man never notice what he has been robbed for. Well, it's the time I did some real work. And now what Hari Singh was thinking, that it was the time to do the real work. I told myself, I am out of practice, and if I don't take the money, he will only waste it on his friends. So now what he says, that he is out of practice, he has done nothing for the last 1 month. And if he don't take the money, Hari Singh thinks that if he doesn't take the money from Anil, he will waste all that money on his friends. After all, he doesn't even pay me, and he doesn't pay him any salary. So he says that I should take the money. So next, what happens? Anil was asleep. A beam of moonlight stepped over the balcony and on the bed. So it was moonlight. So moonlight was falling in the balcony and on the bed also. I sat up on the floor considering the situation. He was just thinking that how he should do his act. If I took the money, I could catch the 10:30 express to Lucknow. And he was thinking that if he take that money right now, he would catch 10:30 express to Lucknow. He would go to Lucknow. And slipping out of the blanket, I crept up to the bed. Now, slipping out of the blanket, he was sleeping in the balcony, so he just came out of the blanket and he quietly crept to the bed near to the bed of Anil. Anil was sleeping peacefully. He was having a peaceful sleep. Anil was sleeping peacefully. His face was clear and unlined. There were no stress marks on his face. Even I had more marks on my face, though mine were mostly scars. Mostly scars they were because of some fights or some accidents. So he had many scars on his face, but Anil's face was quite clear and unlined. There were no marks on his face. My hand slid under the mattress. Now he put his hand under the mattress, searching for the notes. And he searched the notes and he found the notes and he just drew them out without a sound. Without any sound, he just took out the notes from under the mattress. Anil sighed in his deep and turned on his side. Now Anil sighed. Sighed means he took a deep breath in his sleep and turned on his side. Now Anil turned on his side. His face was on Hari Singh's side. Now I was startled and quickly crawled out of the house. So he was surprised, he was shocked, and he immediately quietly crept out of the room. When I was on the road, I began to run. Now when he was on the road, he began to run. I had the notes at my waist, held there by the string of my pajamas. He had tied the note with the string of his pajama. I slowed down to a walk and counted the money. And when he was on the road, what he did, he slowed down and he counted the money. There were 600 rupees in 50s. All were 50 rupees notes and there were total 600 rupees. I could live like an oil-rich Arab for a week or two. So now what he was thinking, because before that he had never got that much amount, 600 rupees, and what he thought that he could live like a rich man. Oil rich Arab means he could live like a rich man for about 1 or 2 weeks. So now when I reached the station, I did not stop at the ticket office. Now when he reached the station, he did not stop at the ticket office. I had never bought a ticket in my life. As he was a thief, he had never bought a ticket. He always traveled without ticket, but dashed straight to the platform. He rushed to the platform. The Lucknow Express was just moving out. Now the Lucknow Express, it was ready to move. It was just moving out, slowly moving out of the station. The train had still to pick up speed. It had still not picked up the speed, and I should have been able to jump into one of the carriages, and it was so easy to catch the train. But I hesitated. But Hari Singh hesitated at this point. He could catch that Lucknow Express, but he stopped for no reason. He could not explain the reason. For some reason I can't explain, I lost the chance to get away. He had lost the chance to get away. He could not catch that train, and he did not know the reason why he did not catch the train. When the train had gone, I found myself standing alone on the deserted platform. And when the train had gone, what he found himself standing alone on the lonely platform. It was all alone because train had left and now there was no one. I had no idea where to spend the night. Now before that he had Anil's room where he could spend the time, but now he had nowhere to go. I had no friends, believing that friends were more trouble than help. And Hari Singh had no friends in his life. Thief had no friends because he considered friends as a trouble rather than help. And I did not want to make anyone curious by staying at one of the small hotels near the station. And he did not want to create doubt in the mind of anyone by staying at any hotel near the station. He did not want to stay in any hotel because otherwise people would doubt him that he is a thief. The only person I knew really well was the man I had robbed. The only person he knew well, who was he? He was Anil, the whom he had robbed. So leaving the station, I walked slowly through the bazaar. Now he had some regrets in his mind, but he slowly walked through the bazaar. In my short career as a thief, I had made a study of men's faces when they had lost their goods. In my short career as a thief. Now, in his career, in his short career, because he was just 15 years old, he had not spent much time in as a thief. So he says that, but he was much experienced. So he had studied people's faces when they had lost their goods, when they had lost their money or something. The greedy man showed fear. The greedy people, they showed fear. Psychology of the people, he is saying that the greedy man, greedy people, they showed fear. The rich man showed anger. Rich man become angry. The poor man showed acceptance. And the poor people, they accept it. What they think? That it is all because of their karma or because of the God's will. So they accept it. But I knew that Anil's face. But he remembered Anil's face. Ki when he discovered the theft, he would show only a touch of sadness. And he thought that when Anil would come to know about this robbery, what he would think? He would be sad only. Not for the loss of money. He would not be worried about the loss of the money. But he would be worried about the loss of trust. He would not, because his trust was broken. He trusted Hari Singh. He wanted to teach him. He wanted to make him educated. He wanted to make him a good person. And his loss, now the trust was broken. And that would be quite hurting for Anil. I found myself in the Maidan and sat down on a bench. Now, Hari Singh, he went to the ground and he sat on the bench, some garden, it was near some garden, and the night was very chilly, it was early November, and a light drizzle added to my discomfort. Already there was light rain, so that was quite uncomfortable. Soon it was raining quite heavily, so later it started raining heavily, my shirt and pajama stuck to my skin, and a cold wind blew the rain across my face. Now it was chilly, wind was blowing, and his shirt and pajama, they were all wet and they were just stuck to his skin, so he was feeling very cold. Then he went back to the bazaar and sat down in the shelter of the cloak tower. Then he went to the bazaar and he sat under the cloak tower. The cloak showed midnight, so it was midnight. I felt for the notes, they were all damp from the rain. So now when he felt the note, when he touched the notes, they were all wet from the rain. Anil's money. In the morning, he would probably have given me 2 or 3 rupees to go to the cinema. But now I had it all. So now Anil's money. He felt the money and he thought that maybe Anil would have given him 2 or 3 rupees to go to cinema. But now he had all the 600 rupees with him. I couldn't cook his meals, run to the bazaar, or learn to write whole sentences anymore. But he had got the money, but now he had missed the chance to cook food for him, had to go to bazaar, or to learn to write full sentences, to be educated. He had lost all the chances of that. I had forgotten about them in the excitement of my theft. Now, in the excitement of getting the money, he had forgotten all about the benefits, all about the advantages that he was getting at Anil's house. Whole sentences, I knew, could one day bring me more than a few hundred rupees. Now what he was thinking, that if I had learned those whole sentences, making those whole sentences, I would have become educated, I could earn more than these 600 rupees. It was a simple matter to steal, and sometimes just as simple to be caught. It was just simple that it was all a matter of stealing the money, and sometimes if you are caught, it's a simple act. But to be really big man, a clever and respected man, was something else. ये बड़ी आसान सी बात थी कि किसी को चोरी कर लेना या पकड़े जाना कुछ भी नहीं है. लेकिन वो क्या सोच रहा है? It is really a big thing to be a big man, clever, respected man. It is really something different, and it was only possible at Anil's, with Anil, in Anil's company, that he could do all that. I should go back to Anil, I told myself, if only to learn and read and write. Now what he was thinking, that he should go back to Anil, so that he could learn to read and write and become an educated person. I hurried back to the room feeling very nervous. Now he went back to Anil's room and he was feeling very nervous. Maybe he would be waking up and he would question him. For it is much easier to steal something than to return it undetected. Because what he was thinking also, that it is really difficult to return something अनडिटेक्टेड. आप बिना किसी को पता लगे अगर आप किसी का कुछ वापस कर रहे हो, चुराना आसान है बट उसको वापस रखना बहुत मुश्किल है बिना पता लगे. आई ओपन द डोर क्वाइटली एंड देन स्टूड इट इन द डोर वे. आई ओपन द डोर क्वाइटली देन स्टूड इन द डोर वे एंड आई जस्ट स्टूड इन द डोर वे जस्ट लुकिंग इन द सिचुएशन इन क्लाउडेड मून लाइट. अनिल वॉज अस्लीप. अनिल वॉज स्टिल स्लीपिंग. आई क्रैप्ट टू द हेड ऑफ द बेड and my hand came up with the notes. I crept to the head of the bed. So now he just quietly went to near to the head of the bed and his hand came up with the notes and he had notes in his hand. I felt the breath on my hand. I remained still for a minute. Then my hand found the edge of the mattress and slipped under it with the notes. And slowly I put these notes, 600 rupees, safely under the mattress again. So he was feeling really sorry for all that and he was worried also that whether Anil would notice all that, he would find that he had robbed him. So he just wanted to do all that undetected. I awoke late next morning to find that Anil had already made the tea because he was waken up all the night. So he woke up late in the morning and before that Anil had already made the tea. He stretched out his hand towards me and he just stretched his hand towards me. There was a 50 rupees note between the fingers. So there was a 50 rupee note he has in his hand. My heart sank. I was really worried. I thought I had been discovered. And what Hari Singh was thinking that he had been caught. Usko pata lag gaya ki maine usko paisa churaya tha. I made some money yesterday, he explained. Now you will be paid regularly. But what Anil told that he had made the money, yes, he had made some money and now he would be paid regularly, he would pay him some salary. My spirits rose, I felt very happy, deeply satisfied. But when I took the note, I saw it was still wet from the night's rain. But when I took the note, मैंने देखा कि वो अभी भी गीला था, तो इसका मतलब क्या था? कि अनिल को वो सब पता चल चुका था कि what I had done with his money. Today we will start writing sentences, he said. And now what Anil said, that today we will start writing sentences. And he had never discussed this thing, why these notes were wet and all that. He did not want to ask any reasons because he was a very trustworthy man. So he knew, but neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. He did not show any reaction. I smiled at Anil in my most appealing way. And the smile came itself without any effort. Now I smiled at him and he smiled at me and that all came naturally. So this is the story that how a person's good behavior, his appealing smile, his good behavior, how it changed a thief's life, how he changed his heart, how he changed his mind. And ultimately he became a good person. So this is all the story. And if we discuss about the theme of this story, that it is really difficult to rob a careless, and as we are told in the story also, that how the thief explained, how Hari Singh explained, that how a greedy person react, how it is easy to rob a greedy man, but it is really difficult to rob a greedy person. Okay, Hari Singh, just he went away with the money. The only person he really knew after robbing that money, that he, the only trusted person, most trusted person was Anil. So he did not want to rob him. That's why he came back. He just put the money under his bed and so this way he became a basic. Now it is all about human values, human relationships. कि अगर आप किसी के साथ बहुत अच्छा बिहेव करते हो, हमें पता भी है कि वो एक चोर है, कुछ ऐसा है, लेकिन फिर भी हम अपनी तरफ से उसके साथ कुछ बैड बिहेव नहीं कर रहे हैं, अच्छा बिहेव कर रहे हैं, अच्छी रिलेशनशिप्स हैं, अच्छी वैल्यूज़ हम पुट करते हैं, डेफिनेटली ही वुड बिकम अ चेंज्ड मैन लेटर ऑन. सो दिस इज़ ऑल गिवन इन द स्टोरी दैट दिस इज़ ऑल अबाउट बेसिक ह्यूमन वैल्यूज़ एंड रिलेशनशिप्स. सो दिस इज़ ऑल अबाउट द स्टोरी एंड द थीम, क्वेश्चन आंसर्स एंड ऑल दैट वी विल डिस्कस थ्रू व्हाट्सएप. विद दैट, थैंक यू.